Hello friends, I'm Kanchan from Aculmec Technologies and you are welcome to our show Roundtable Discussion. Today we have a very interesting panel guest and let me introduce you to all of you, to you. Now we have Ritu Gupta who is CEO of a PR agency Four Seasons. A part of this, she is also teaching in one of the prestigious colleges in Delhi. She's a lecturer of media relations and PR relations here in Delhi. We also have Indra Sharma, who is the head of the department of one of the prestigious school of the subject physical training. She has been awarded by the government for her contribution in education. Welcome to the show, Indra. Welcome to the show, Ritu.
Thank you.
We have Sitesh Srivastav, who is an IT professional. A part of this is closely related to radio broadcasting, and he is also having very keen interest in corporate trainings. So, welcome to the show, Sitesh. How are you doing today?
I'm well, Kanchan. Thanks for inviting, and thanks for the lovely panel that we have.
We have Chandrakant, who is a co-founder of Aculmec Technologies. And he has a great interest in aviation and space-related subjects. So, welcome to the show, Chandrakant. How are you doing today?
I'm fine, Kanchan. Thank you for your invite. And looking forward to this very powerful discussion today.
Yes.
So, we have a great subject today and would like to know your opinion about what we lost in this pandemic. We are just nearing to the March. So, that means we are covering 1 year of this pandemic era, though we have vaccination here, and that's a good news. But I would like to know from any one of you who can start on this topic, what really we lost during this pandemic?
So Kanchan, I really want to start with this as we have started 1 year of pandemic, and when I look back, I find that this last 1 year is very strange, has been very strange year. But like many of you, we started 2020 and also now 2021 with plans, hope, dreams and desires, many of which had to be rethought, rescaled, scaled differently, and even abandoned also. However, this great reset that was 2020 is not all doom and gloom. We have found many new ways of working that may represent a healthier balance between our work life and our home life. We have also found new tools online, virtual, connected to a webcam that allow us easier access to colleagues, experts, relatives, friends all over the world. As we have all been encouraged to mask up and socially distance from each other, we have found the tools to make the separation and distance irrelevant. So that's what I want to say.
Yes, it's a very good point that we have found new ways of communication. But what I feel is that we are lacking a social interaction, which is it's very important, because as a human race, it's very, very essential to have a social interaction, and that is how we grow. So what are your ideas on this subject, Sitesh?
Well, Kanchan, let me put it in a very in precise way, I feel. What we lost is a little bit of a trust in the science and the research fraternity, who could not see this coming. Despite having SARS, despite having so many other smaller versions of it, Ebola a few years back, and MERS in the Hong Kong, Asia Pacific region. So despite so much of funding available throughout the world, in all the developed and also in not so developed countries, the science fraternity could not see this thing coming. That is one thing that was lost, I feel. The other thing that was lost is the trust in the media, because there was either no media or too much of media on in between. And therefore it needs, I think these two were lost. And because these, we are dependent on these two, the media as well as the scientific fraternity, I think little bit of, you know, the trust on ourselves and our old ways of living that we have left and moved forward in the name of progress, that was lost. And I think, as Ritu says, after 1 year of this pandemic, we are more than aware of what our grandfathers and fathers and great grandfathers used to do and live. That's what I have to say.
Yes. I also want to know your views on this subject, Indraji, when you are closely associated with children and on daily basis you teach children and meet them. So what we lost exactly when we talk about our children and their growth?
Yes, the socialization is very important for children. Like they have been studying, they have improved their computer skills, it has sharpened, but somewhere they were not interacting with the other children, which is very important at this stage. It's very important for their growth. It's very important they interact with other children, they play outside. That they have missed during this time. The children have really missed this time. But sometimes in adversities, children, they have learned so much. They have learned other things also. And I feel this, that the socialization was very important for the children.
And yes, I feel that you raised a very important... Yes. So I feel you raised a very important point that socializing is missing and which is very important. I would like to know from CK that how he really reacts on these ideas and these points when there's a lot of worries among parents, among national leaders about some issues which are we are discussing. How you feel, what we lost in this period of pandemic?
Well, Kanchan, thank you for selecting this remarkable subject. I think we have not lost anything, but we have actually lost one thing, which is living in denial. All the things that we are seeing today have been around for last 20 years. We were not accepting it. You know, it has been recommended that Industry 4.0 will come, and finally it has come. What I'm disappointed is that we had one wretched virus to tell us that, hey, Industry 4.0 is there, and you know, virus has to teach us these things. And you know what is happening? The gig economy, everybody has been talking for last 10 years. Now it is finally here. Indraji mentioned about physical connect. I think the physical connect is much more than ever. Earlier, you could talk to 100 people with your time of, you know, spending 1 hour. Now you can talk to 10,000 people. People who are doing gaming, they are now flourishing. You know, they are doing gaming for 11 hours, 12 hours, and all sorts of games are being played on the internet. Gaming industry is booming. If you look at the YouTube platforms and Facebook, their infrastructure is booming. Their bandwidth utilization is booming. Everywhere we see boom. So I think we have not lost anything. What we have gained is a new way of embracing Industry 4.0.
So that means we are talking about this loss, and do you feel really it's a myth? Anybody can take this question. Is it a myth that we are, as CK has mentioned, it is a denial, we are living in a denial, but then many people will even today come up and say that, yes, we have lost something. Like if you talk to the agricultural sector, the farmers will say that, yes, we have lost. We are not able to get a right amount. We are not able to sell our products because there was a pandemic. People were not buying. And if we really go into a marketing segment, then again, we have same type of opinion, which is expressed by head of the sales department of any company. It says, no, we are not selling anything because people are not buying. So what do you think about this, Sitesh?
Well, I think, Kanchan, that CK has raised a very interesting point that we have been living in denial. At the same time, I would just add to his point. Last 10 years, or last 12 years to be precise, the amount of consumption that we are having with our electronics, gadgets, internet, and our superfluous lifestyle in middle, even in the middle class incomes, that has actually made us dependent on so many things without asking a question. Whether it is electricity, whether it is medicines, whether it is home delivery of food and every essential items, we suddenly started thinking that everything is doable, everything is feasible, and therefore we can overlook the basics. We can overlook the essentials. We can overlook the not so fortunate part of the world. In fact, the virus, the wretched virus, as CK says, comes from one of the biggest economy in the world. And that it was unapprehended, it was uncontrolled. And then when it was released, it was controlled through the World Health Organization for such a long time. So definitely we have lost so many lives. Definitely we have lost the credibility of the scientific fraternity. And definitely we have lost to understand that there are some basic principles of human living that never change. And a global village concept may be as good as it gets, but it may not solve all the problems of this world. That's what I want to say.
So Ritu, you interact with all grown-up children, you go to college and teach pretty smart students at the moment. So what is your reaction, as CK has mentioned that the technologies were already there at place, but we were so scared to use them. But when pandemic came and we started using more and more. So what has changed in the lives of a student when we pre-pandemic and post, not post as yet, but still we feel that we are just about to be out of this pandemic. But my question is, how children react to this?
I think what children miss, very frankly, they miss in-person interaction with the teacher. They miss in-person interaction with each other. The freedom to, you know, grab a cup of coffee, meet someone face-to-face. The, you know, that thing they are really missing. And also, we have, you know, made online teaching, it's getting better and better each day. But one-to-one interaction definitely is not there. And plus, you cannot force students to do something. What I personally miss is when I teach, when I take lectures, and even the other teachers also, we see that students are not that reactive. They're not following the discipline which they would have had followed in the one-to-one class. Because most of the time, students, they are on unmute mode, mute mode, and their cameras are off. So most of the time the classes are is just one-way interaction. So that I personally feel is not right. Even the students, they feel that the discipline, there was a way in living the life. But I'm sure that things are going to get normal each day.
Okay, so Indra, actually a couple of days back, I have heard that children who are studying in 9th and 10th, they started going to the school. And there was a clipping which I happened to see on the social media. And the children were saying there's nothing comparable to online classes, not compared to the classes we are attending, the offline classes. So I would like to know how you really feel about this this difference in online and offline classes, and how you can really find that where the students are most satisfied. You know that online classes are also giving many information. Much of the platform is very, very advanced, and a student can learn anything on online. But then again, when I saw the clip in any of these social media platforms, I realized that students are longing to go to the school. So what you really advise and how you will react to this statement?
Now, children must be like, they like to go to school, meet their friends, teachers, their interaction. They all love to do that. But classroom teaching, in my school, at least I know that we already had smart boards. Teachers were teaching the smart boards. No? They were all familiar with the all the system. And I think it was not very difficult for them to switch over to online. But that is not in all schools. Some schools, some privileged, some schools had the smart boards. And this knowledge, their teaching ability and the use of smart boards helped them, helped every one of us to teach children online when there was a pandemic. And teacher students always, when they go to school, they meet friends, how they enjoy going to school in buses, coming back, recess time, game time, all this, this they have missed. Otherwise, learning have really taken place. They have learned a lot. It's not that they have not, they have gained so much of knowledge.
We had been discussing about that we lost this, but what is one thing which really has, you know, has done a great impact on day-to-day life of people? I would like to ask this from CK.
Well, let me start where Ritu left. See, there is a Industry 4.0 which is going to come in any way, and it has already arrived here. So there is a gap in the market, and the biggest gap is in the ed tech, education technology. I think the points that the panelists are making is that, you know, people are missing the friendship, breakups, makeups, you know, those kind of things which happens usually in a school. So I think there is a requirement for smart entrepreneurs to fill that gap, use the online medium to come out with this AI-based learning systems. So when we say that people are putting themselves on mute, you know, why they should be able to put it on mute when you have AI and you can recreate the same environment that you see in your school? That means you can have breakout sessions, you can have tea break, coffee break, and you can maintain social distance and study on a new platform. So I think there is a K-12 system which is already there. The schools in India and many other countries need to adapt to this K-12 system, online level of education and also certification. So that system brings all the nuances of a physical activity which you will anyway do in your school. So I think that is where we are. We should not be looking at it with a narrow mind. The changes are permanent. Whatever changes have happened in 2020 are going to stay there for next 5 to 6 years. So I think sooner we realize that these changes are real, better it would be for us, and look ahead, see what are the new changes that we are going to say. And as somebody said, change is the only constant. So the changes are going to happen. We have to keep adapting to it.
Definitely. It's a very good description about the loss we have been facing during this pandemic. But actually what I feel, there, we are a very big country and everybody don't really gel with the idea of technology. They don't even gel with the idea of social distancing. People are taking advantage. They want to go out. Even for marriages also, it is said that only 50 guests can come and come into the venue of a marriage. So my point is that somehow, somewhere we have changed our lifestyle, not here in India, but all over the world. Now, we are still learning how to really cope up with this kind of lifestyle, this kind of mentality, this kind of workflow. So are we ready to really convert this loss into a gain-gain situation, Sitesh?
Well, Kanchan, the mask has to become a part of our body. It can be added as a probably 300th organ of our body going forward. That is the interesting part. And this was there always in the Asia Pacific, especially in Japan, where a normal flu would have attracted a mask by people. In India, we have learned it a very, very hard way, but I cannot say that we have learned it in a real way. The other thing is that the lifestyle changes, as CK says, is going to stay, and there is no compromise on that. How much we can compromise and how much we can bring back the great glorious days pre-pandemic times, I really want to see or feel that. What I also understand is the lifestyle of this is not a guarantee for another pandemic. As we are seeing, new strains are coming, and we are also seeing that there could be another more potent, more fatal pandemics, which are generally recurring after every 100 years. So 100 years is far enough for all of us here on this day today. But the new strains are possible. And we really don't know what is happening in those labs, wherever they are, whether it is in any country. Who is looking at the compliance of those? And why the data is not coming out? Why Dr. Fauci from US had to cut away from his government standpoint and make his own channel of communication? That is a great example. Another thing that I really try to despise is one side of people says that this pandemic has taught all of us that the good old days of living, you know, having home food and healthy living, healthy habits, and all such, so much of knowledge or gyan that has passed through last year in 2020. The other side says that, did we really need to go through this kind of a wretched virus to feel this? I don't think so. So Greta Thunberg said, you know, this is a Earth's way of healing. But did we really need to go through that? I don't agree with Greta. So there are these things that will always be there. But from a corporate perspective, as everybody here in the panel says that children are missing this, I must tell you, I am missing going to office, because the real productivity gain is there for the office. While sitting at home, I can do a lot of things that are my own choice. But from a working perspective, it is very important to be in office, to feel the culture and to enhance it. That's what I want, feel.
Yes, CK also wants to add something on this comment. Yes, CK.
Yes, Satish, I fully agree with you. And when I was in Africa, we had limited transportation. I mean, we had to keep our own cars and drivers. And many times you had to work from your apartments. So, you know, what I used to do is dress up in the morning, wear a suit, because you never know, you know, when you will be called for a meeting, and continue working from your home till the time you're going out. So I think the whole point is that it's in your mind, you know. So what is happening today is that 20 years back, I was in an extraordinary situation where I had to dress up and feel like as if I'm working from an office, although I'm at home. But right now, everybody has to do that, and they have to learn this new way. And Kanchan mentioned about entertainment, joining birthday parties. I think there are enough facility available where you can do karaoke. In fact, many of my friends are celebrating using karaokes and you know, things like that. And Satish, you mentioned about office. There are virtual office products available today where you can actually create a virtual official environment. What is missing is for the children, because the school fraternity has not woken up to the reality. They are still going in the old way. I can show the teacher in front of the camera. 40 people will tune in to that stream, and then they will do whatever they want. They can mute their camera, they can mute their microphone, etc. I think the innovation is waiting to happen. I'm sure somebody like Byju's will come up with a very advanced AI-based learning system, and all of these schools will be out of the business very soon. So the whole evolution method is either you evolve or you perish. I think this is the biggest learning we have from this pandemic. We need to evolve with the changes, because these changes are permanent. It is starting the gig economy. Next 21, 22, 23 will be the year of online workers. 50% of the workforce will be available online. There is no need to go to office. Google has already announced for 3 years, they will not be calling their employees to office. So I think it's a reality in front of our own eyes. How can we deny it?
Yes, very well said, CK. But the thing is that we have lost something. What we have lost is that we had been living it is like living a pattern of life, which we are missing, and we are learning day by day, going through that pattern. I would like to summarize what we have discussed today. First is social distancing, which we are really doing online. As Ritu said, that we have some problems, like students are not as disciplined as they are in an offline mode. Like Indra said, that social distancing has created a havoc among children, and of course among parents also, because they don't have a free time for themselves. Because earlier children used to go out and they can manage their timetable accordingly. Like Sitesh said, that things were already there. There are some missing aspect of living life, like going to the office. But then CK said, we can counter, we have everything available. So I think to summarize this discussion is that, yes, pandemic will remain. The effect of pandemic will remain nearly for 3-4 years more. And we have to accustom with the change. And I think that change, whatever we have lost, I think there it should be converted into positive vibes, and we should evolve. This is a great time to evolve ourselves, evolve the way of we are living. And of course, relationship also need a little evolution. So it was lovely talking to you, all of you. Thanks for joining on this important discussion. Till next time we meet. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kanchan. Thank you, Kanchan. Have a
great
day.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.